I would like to welcome all of you for this year's first Prerna Festival, and that too entitled as Life with Selfie. How many of you at least once have taken selfie of your own self? Almost everyone. I include myself also. My head is. But I would say that I had taken selfie only once, and aap bolenge kya prabhu ji aap bhi sab, but I did it when once I was in Jagannath Puri, and near that there is a place in Bhuvaneshwar, it's called as Remuna. You might be aware of that Remuna. There is a very beautiful deity of the lordship Kheerchor Gopinath. So there I was taking the kheer, and then we thought of taking selfie while drinking the kheer, and we posted in the group so that to inspire boys that I am drinking kheer now, so you will also enjoy when we'll go in yatra. So eagerly waiting for you to enjoy the nectarian drink that was called as Amrut Keli. So once only I had taken my selfie. So when we come for such kinds of Prerna festivals, we come to gather some inspiration, gather some Prerna, take Prerna with us, you know. Now this Prerna is not the name of the girl, by the way. Because we get all these things in temple only, you know. Aradhana, Puja, Sugandhi. So all these things we get in temple. So many times boys, they come with different intentions that maybe I'll gather something. So you might have come over here to gather some Prerna. So let me first clear this to you, that I will be speaking in all the languages which I know. It may include Marathi, Hindi, English, Sanskrit also. So kindly bear with me. So there is some technical error happening over here, because of which the presentation is not starting. It will just take a few minutes to run. So we come to gather some inspiration, we come to gather some Prerna, and maybe when we implement, then we get some results out of it. So I want to share a very nice example of a person, Mr. George Mestral. So Mr. George Mestral, he was an electrical engineer from Switzerland. So one time he, along with his dog, went for a stroll in a forest, and when he was in forest, when he came back, he saw an amazing thing. He saw on his pant and on the furs of his dog a kookalbur. Special kookalburs were there attached to it. Kookalbur, samajhta hai? Landga, landga. Bachpan mein hum log phekte the ek dusre ke upar, pata hai aapko? Uske kehte kookalbur. So kookalbur were attached to the furs of the dog and his own pant. And this person took an inspiration from these kookalburs. Landga se prerna liya usne. Hum log to khelte the. And he invented this Velcro out of it. केवल लांडगा से प्रेरणा लेके उसने क्या बनाया? वेलप्रो. और हम लोग एक दूसरे के ऊपर लांडगा फेंक के मजा करते थे. सो दिस इज हाउ वी डिराइव इंस्पिरेशन. नाउ इंस्पिरेशन कैन कम इन पॉजिटिव वे एज वेल एज निगेटिव वे. दिस ऑल्सो कैन इंस्पायर यू अलॉट. सो मेनी पीपल, when the topic was announced, they were asking me, what are you going to take in the seminar? Selfie ke bare mein kitna bol sakte hai? And frankly to tell you, almost 40 to 50 messages I received, please Prabhu ji ye dikha lena selfie prerna mein. It's from my side. So this is, so I try to gather all these, whatever people sitting amongst you, only some of them are here. So I said that yes, I am going to speak something different, something unique. So first of all, let me give justice to the topic of selfie and let me share some brief history of selfie. Actually, the selfie word was added in Oxford Dictionary in 2013 and it was declared as word of the year. And when it was invented, actually Mr. Nathan Hope from Australia in the year 2002, once while driving he met with an accident and he collapsed on his lips. So his lips were broken, so he took the photo of that, you know, his own broken lips and shared it to the doctor, you know, this thing has happened. And that time he was not knowing what to call that. So in Australia there is a, you know, etymology, it means science of words. So they apply at the end of many words E, I-E, flowery, beddy, so self-E. So that's how the word was invented in 2002. Before that also many things were there. So this is the brief history of selfie. And what is the Oxford definition of selfie, by the way? A photograph that one has taken of oneself, typically one taken with a smartphone or a webcam and shared via social media. That is the Oxford definition of selfie for your information. Now since then, you know how much people are addicted to these selfies, you know. Wherever they go, whenever we take some boys to a picnic, you know, always they are with their smartphone, with their selfies, posting, sharing, and you know. So this keep happening to such an extent that they can't hold back taking selfies. That much addiction is there. Just to give an example, प्राचीन काळात लोक आपले आई वडील मुलं बाळ पत्नी यांना सोडून एकांतच राहायचे, त्याला संन्यास म्हणत. कलियुगात त्याला ऑनलाईन राहणं म्हणतात. ऑनलाईन. सो पीपल आर सो मच ऑफ ॲडिक्टेड टू सेल्फीज दॅट लास्ट इयर वेन वी वेंट फॉर टेकिंग बाथ इन कुंभमेला, यु नो, शाही स्नान, साधू है तो कैसे जा सकते हैं, तो ऐसे घुस गए. शाही स्नान वे टेकिंग एंड इन द फ्रंट देर वॉज अ बोर्ड रिटन नो सेल्फी जोन. नहीं तो साधु पानी में रखे सेल्फी शेयर करते. सो दिस मे हैपन, सो दे हैव टू राइट. एंड मेनी प्लेसेज इट इज रिटन नाउ नो सेल्फी जोन, नो सेल्फी जोन. सो डोंट टेक दैट मेनी सेल्फी सेल्फी सेल्फी. पीपल आर सो मच ऑफ एडिक्टेड नाउ डेज. द डिसीज विच वॉज कॉल्ड एज टेनिस एल्बो, Sachin Tendulkar had that. Now it has been termed as selfie elbow. The disease that may happen to you. So people drink selfie, eat selfie, and sometimes people sing selfie. Le 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 selfie le re beta, something like that. So people do that. एक बार एक पत्नी हस्बैंड को फोन करके पूछती, कहाँ हो आप? तो बोलता है कि जरा बिजी हूँ, बात नहीं कर सकता, बाद में बात करेंगे. तो बीवी बोलती है, आप सेल्फी निकाल के भेजो ना मुझे, मतलब कहाँ पे वो समझ में आ जाएगा. तो बोलता है कि बोल देना बिजी हूँ, बाद में भेजूँगा. अभी क्या, अभी आपकी जगह से बाहर आओ, सेल्फी निकालो और मुझे भेजो, नहीं तो देखती हूँ. तो बेचारा हस्बैंड क्या करता, सेल्फी निकाल के बाहर आके भेजना पड़ा उसको. So selfie is being taken nowadays as evidence. Where were you? What you were doing? Status of WhatsApp is also considered as real status nowadays. One boy, he was there in our yatra. So he has changed his status. He's in yatra enjoying. And he changed his status to, you know, feeling very sick. And that crying symbol emojis. Just to cheat. And the height of selfie is this, people are so much addicted to this disease of taking selfie. मेरे को किसी ने मैसेज किया, अगर आपके पास कुछ भारत रत्न अवार्ड बचा है तो इस बंदे को दे दो. लास्ट मोमेंट ना, लास्ट गुड बाय टू दिस पर्सन आई एम डूइंग, दिस फेलो इज टेकिंग सेल्फी. सो दैट मच ऑफ एडिक्शन इज देयर. Scientists, they have came up with a word, you might be knowing, narcissism. and for them it's now very easy to calculate. Scientists have announced a new unit to accurately measure narcissism, number of selfies per hour. How many number of selfies you take? And what is this narcissism actually? Extreme selfishness with a grandiose view of one's own talents and craving for admiration. Wanting admiration from others. How many people will like it? So dear friends, today we have gathered over here. आज आप लोग दंगल देखने जा सकते थे लेकिन आप अपना मंगल करने के लिए आए हो यहाँ पे. सो वी हैव गैदर्ड ओवर हियर. सो व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू टेक टुडे, वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट दिस सेल्फी. आई हैव मेड इट इनटू एन एक्रोनिम SELFIE, लाइफ टू बी लिव्ड विथ दिस सेल्फी. एंड आई गारंटी यू द मोमेंट यू लिव योर लाइफ विथ दिस सेल्फी एक्रोनिम, your life will be different than yesterday. What is this S? Substance versus show off. Life of substance versus life of show off. Next is life of edification versus life of degradation. Life of love versus life of likes. Life of focus versus life of distraction. Life of instant gratification versus life of long-term payoffs. And last E, life of enjoyment versus life of enlightenment. So let us see all these one by one for coming duration of an hour. Life of substance versus life of show-off. Nowadays people wants to do so much of show-off. दिखावा करना चाहते हैं, राइट? वांट्स टू शो ऑफ. डीपी को मेरे को एक बहुत सुंदर शब्द मिला है, डीपी दिखावटी फोटो. पीपल एडिट एंड पीपल प्ले सो मेनी ट्रिक्स विद द फोटो एंड देन दे अपलोड. यू नो, डू यू नो हिंदी ट्रांसलेशन ऑफ सेल्फी? खुद खींचो. देयर इज हिंदी ट्रांसलेशन ऑफ व्हाट्सएप, जन धन निःशुल्क गप शप योजना. दिस इज व्हाट्सएप. मेनी टाइम्स आई सीट फॉर अ क्लास, यू नो, गिविंग क्लास, एंड मेनी टाइम्स आई सी सम ऑफ द बॉयज इन द बैंक, यू नो, दे आर जस्ट. मेरा फ्रेंड उनको बोलता है, खाली मुंडी न व्हाट्सएप ढूंढी, समथिंग लाइक दैट. यू नो, पहले का काम क्या म्हणी असायच्या, म्हणी माहिती तुम्हाला? आणि मराठीमध्ये एक प्रश्न असायचा, म्हणी पूर्ण करा. त्यामुळे एक आता मी पण तुम्हाला एक प्रश्न विचारतो, मी म्हणतो ती म्हण तुम्ही पूर्ण करा. स्वामी तिनी जगाचा, आजची म्हण आहे, स्वामी तिनी जगाचा चार्जर विना भिकारी. यू डोंट हॅव एनी चार्जर, यू डोंट हॅव एनिथिंग. एक ना धड भाराभर ग्रुप मेंबर. सो दीज आर द स्लोगन्स टुडे. ॲडमिन इट्स ट्रान्सलेटेड अ झुंड नियंत्रक. सो पीपल वॉन्ट्स टू डू शो ऑफ. जब घर में बनियन पहनते ना सब लोग, कितने लोग बनियन पहनते, बनियन शर्ट, मेनी आर देयर, एवरीवन. जब इस प्रकार का बनियन हो जाता था ना, मेरी मदर मेरे को डांटती थी और बोलती थी अभी फेंक. एंड दिस इज फॉर सेल on Zara website, you see, this is the brand. And people will wear this and show this, I am wearing this Zara, and post on their Facebook post. This fashion, just for the purpose of show. This fashion. Going further, victory is of two types. One is public victory, another is called as private victory. Public victory means what I want is the public's attention. Have you heard the name Hiranyakashipu? Hiranyakashipu was such a deadly demon. He had control over weather. Even all the demigods would come and bend his wings. That was his power. so much of public victory he was behind, but what happened to him? He did tapasya to become immortal for 60,000 years, and after that he lived only for 5 years. And then he was operated open stomach surgery by Narasimha Dev. So that happened and he died. So he was least bothered about what is inside victory, what is private victory, but just show off. एकदा एक मुलगा गोट्या, त्याचं नाव गोट्या, वडिलांना विचारतो पप्पा लग्नाला जायचंय कोणता कोट घालू जेणेकरून सगळे माझ्याकडे बघतील. पप्पा तंबाखू खात खात, कोणता कोट घाल, पेटी कोट, सगळे लोक तुझ्याकडे बघतील बाबा, सगळे तुझ्याकडे बघतील. सो वी हॅव टू लुक हिअर व्हॉट काइंड ऑफ लाईफ वी वॉन्ट टू लिव, अ लाईफ ऑफ शो ऑफ, just live for the purpose of showing ourselves to others, or the life of inner substance. Hiranyakashipu is the best example of public victory, and on the contrary Prahlad, his own son, is the example of private victory. So when you are striving to become privately victorious, developing those inner virtues, good qualities, character, then private victory is achieved, and simultaneously public victory is also achieved. There is no need to show off. So people nowadays, they want to show off, they want to enjoy to such an extent that people cheat upon. And to give an example, here is a small clip for all of you. So this is how people wants to just show off to each other, but the reality is different. So therefore we say life of substance versus life of show off. Dear friends, you must be knowing this great person. Who is he? Mother Teresa. Famous for what? Famous for contribution, social service, working for poor, working for helpless people. Externally looks beautiful. Not so. If she enters into this competition of becoming Miss World, will she get the award? No. Our father of the nation, famous for ahimsa, patriotism, so many things everyone carries on their notes in their pockets. And if he enters into this competition of Mr. World, will he get the award? No. Why? So are these two personalities less than the personalities which are showed on the right side of yours? No way. They are so famous that Miss World, Mr. World, they come and go. But the fame of these personalities, because they looked for private victory in their life, public victory was gained automatically. And therefore it's said that beauty is what you feel about yourself, not about what you see in the mirror. And what you see about yourself is what you see within, the private victory, the inside righteous, virtuous qualities of a person. So we want to become beautiful, we want to become sundar in the eyes of these mortal men. But if you want to really become beautiful and handsome, try to become beautiful not in the eyes of mortal men, but try to become beautiful in the eyes of immortal man, immortal person, that is supreme personality of Godhead, Krishna or Lord Ram. So try to become beautiful in their eyes. And there was one such great person who was internally beautiful, has gained a lot of private victory and public victory followed behind him. And that personality, you know, he was Hanumanji. And he is showing, breaking his heart, breaking his chest, showing to others what should be inside, what should be sought for. Are dikhne ko bandar hai, lekin andar se sundar hai. Lekin andar se sundar hai. This is what is to be sought for, to be sought after. And same thing is being spoken by Lord Krishna in Gita also. Next, E. S stands for first life of substance versus show off. Next is E. Life of edification versus life of degradation. Edification means unnati, pragati. Your manasik unnati, that is the correct dictionary definition if you want. Krishna has also said that one should strive for his own progress, pragati. Uddharedatmanatmanam natmanam avasadayet atmaivayatmano bandur atmaivaripuratmanah. That's what Krishna says, that one should uddharet means uplift. Atmana atmanam. Uplift yourself, uplift your consciousness with the help of mind, but not degrade yourself. Avasadayet. Avasad is degradation and uddharet is upgradation or edification. Your mind is your best friend. Your mind can become your worst enemy. Therefore, control the mind and live a life of edification. This Sankranti, which we have celebrated on 14th of Jan, these dates are very familiar. You know, 14th of Jan is famous for one thing. And then 14th of Feb is about to come, is famous for something else. So we have this experience of flying kite, right? How many of you have played with this? Almost everyone. We fly kite, you know. Our life is also equal to kite. Now what is the purpose of kite? The purpose of kite is to go high up in the air. For it to go high, it should be connected to the source thread. For kite to go high, there is the need of favorable wind also. So when we see these three things in relation to kite, similarly these three things also apply to our life. First thing is going high. How do you go high now? For these three things, lesson from kite, I have chosen three Bhagavad Gita verses which exactly speak the same. The first thing is going high. Krishna speaks about this in Bhagavad Gita 14th chapter. Urdhvam gacchanti sattvastha madhye tishtanti rajasa jaghanya guna vrittistha ado gacchanti tamasa. Krishna is saying that urdhvam, it means upar jate hai wo log jo sattva mein sthit hote hai, sattva gun mein. Urdhvam gacchanti sattvastha madhye tishtanti rajasa. Those who are situated in the mode of passion, they will stay there. Adho gacchanti tamasa. Adha means to go down. Those who are situated in the mode of ignorance, they will go down. So kite has to go up. So similarly, if we also have to go up in our life, we should be situated in which mode? Goodness, passion or ignorance? Mode of goodness, that is called as sattva guna. I have a separate topic itself going beyond three modes. But just to give you a very, what we can say, superficial understanding of what three modes are. There are three brothers in one family. One is in mode of goodness, one is in passion, one is in ignorance. So we ourselves can judge ourselves based on these three brothers, which category I belong to. Mr. Ravan, mode of passion, wants to acquire a lot of wealth. No, he snatched, actually Lanka was not belonging to him. He snatched it from his brother Kuvera. Kuvera was the owner of Lanka. Then he, you know, snatched, defeated him in fight and then took away. We have Mr. Kumbhakarna in the mode of ignorance, just sleep. And another brother, we have Mr. Vibhishan in the mode of goodness. So when we cultivate mode of goodness in our life, meeting with people who are in the mode of goodness, eating the food that is in the mode of goodness, then we uplift our consciousness. Urdhvam gacchanti sattvastha. Then kite of our life will go high when we cultivate this mode of goodness in our life. The next step is to stay connected with the scripture, to stay connected with the source, because there has to be a thread for kite to go high in the sky. So the thread in the life of a kite of a life is the scriptures. Stay connected to the scriptures. When we disconnect ourselves from the scriptures, then havoc is created in our life. That's what Krishna speaks about this in Bhagavad Gita in 16th chapter. Yah shastra vidhim utsrujya vartate kama karatah na sasiddhim avapnoti na sukham na paramgatim. Yah shastra vidhim utsrujya. One who gives up scriptures, one who disconnects himself from the scriptures and behaves whimsically, vartate kama karatah na sasiddhim avapnoti na sukham na paramgatim. He will not obtain siddhi, he will not obtain any perfection, no sukha and no higher destination. So when we disconnect ourselves from the scriptures, then we will not be happy. Or in our kite language, we will not go high because we are not connected to the source. No matter how good quality kite it is, if the thread is not there, will it fly? No. So that thread of scriptures has to be there to be connected to the supreme source, that is Krishna. And scriptures, they help us making our choice muscle strong. Many times we have to take choices in our life, make decisions in our life. Just like before coming, you might have to choose whether should I go for prayerna, this is Saturday evening, or whether should I go for watching a movie, right? Choices. At every step in our life, we have to make choices, make decisions in our life. So when we read scriptures, like when we go to gym, what happens? We build our bodily muscles, right? We become strong and sturdy. Similarly, when we are connected with the scriptures, then what happens? Our choice muscles become strong. So what kind of choices? People have n number of choices nowadays, right? Which cell phone to buy? My God, n number of choices. Which shirt to purchase? Zara wala, jo dikhaya tha. And by the way, this Zara, in Marathi there is also a word called as Zarya. There's n number of holes in it. Jo log cigarette nahi peete, wo log brahmalok jate hain. Jo log daru nahi peete, wo log indralok jate hain. और जो दोनों करते हैं वो जसलोक जाते हैं, जसलोक हॉस्पिटल. जो नहीं पिएगा वो इंद्रलोक, जो नहीं पिएगा वो ब्रह्मलोक, जो दोनों करेगा वो जसलोक. सो स्क्रिप्चर्स डिफाइन, दे फोर्टिफाई अवर चॉइस मसल्स, व्हाट चॉइसेस टू मेक. एंड देयरफॉर देयर इज नाइस सेइंग, बीइंग मेल इज अ मैटर ऑफ बर्थ, बीइंग मैन इज अ मैटर ऑफ एज, but being gentleman is a matter of choice. So when we develop the choice muscles, then there is a chance of us becoming gentleman. One time a sage like this in saffron robes, he went to America for some seminar. After giving the seminar, when he was coming out of the session, he saw a man was discussing with a lady, and then the lady was speaking to the man, why this person does not dress like a gentleman? Does not dress like a gentleman. What kind of dress he is wearing? Look, shame on him. When this sadhu, when this sage heard this, he immediately went there and said, Mr. and my dear madam, in your country, gentleman is made by your tailor. But the country from which I am coming, gentleman is made by the person's character, not the teller. So if you are handsome, you will open someone's eyes. When you are intelligent, you will open someone's mind. But when you are gentleman, you can open someone's heart. So therefore, let us become handsome, intelligent, gentleman, and become an instrument for transformation of the world. The next thing for the kite to go up is having favorable wind. And scriptures also speak about this. Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says in 4th chapter, he compares this favorable wind to association of favorable people. association of like-minded people. Tadviddhi pranipate na pariprasne na sevaya upadekshantite jnanam jnaninas tattvadarshinaha. Krishna is saying, go and surrender to great souls who have understood the truth of life. Inquire from them submissively. They will share the same truth with you. So when association of saintly people, we allow ourselves to flow in that association, then what will happen? Kite of our life will go high. So when we are discussing about this life of kite, to go high, it means to cultivate the mode of goodness in us. To stay connected to the source, we need to read scriptures. And to have the favorable wind for kite to go high, we need saintly association. Going further, in our acronym L, life full of love versus life full of likes. Life full of likes. Everyone wants fulfillment in their life, which needs to be sought after by seeking love. But we seek it by hankering more and more likes. And therefore we need to correct the life equation. That happiness will come, that fulfillment in our heart will come, not by just likes, but by love which we gather. So in regards to equation, in one exam, one question was asked, a general exam wherein everyone can appear. The question was this: prove papa equal to mama. Prove. So when it was asked to a medical student, he said it's out of syllabus. When it was given to accountant, he said no way I can solve this. And when it was given to a lawyer, he said I can't prove this. And then it was a turn of an engineer. So okay, let me try. And then he tried. Pressure is equal to force upon area, so P is equal to F upon A, so F is equal to PA, equation number 1. According to Newton's second law, force is equal to mass into acceleration, so F is equal to MA. So from 1 and 2 we have PA equal to MA, and then squaring both sides we have PA square equal to MA square, and then papa equal to mama. Making the right equation of our life. Life is defined not by how many likes you get, but life is defined by how much love do you have for others who are around you. So today, life is made by so many likes. It's like seeing oneself through the lenses of others. How much they give me their like. But sometimes when you don't get those many likes, then what happens? Frustration. A boy came to me. He started crying literally. Oh Prabhuji, kya hai na ki kuch log jo hai vulgar photos dal dete, unko kahi sare likes milte hai. Main kuch zindagi ka achha quote dalta hoon. मेरे को ग्रुप से ही बाहर निकाल दिया उन्होंने. एक्सपायर्ड ग्रुप मेंबर डेड. तो मुझे उसे गीता समझानी पड़ी. फिर व्हाट्सएप गीता. व्हाट इज व्हाट्सएप गीता? पिछले मैसेज का पश्चाताप मत करो, अगले मैसेज की चिंता भी मत करो, अपने करंट मैसेज में ही प्रसन्न रहो. जब तुम नहीं थे तभी भी मैसेजिंग चल रहा था, जब तुम नहीं रहोगे तभी भी मैसेजिंग चलता रहेगा. जो मैसेज आज तुम्हारा है कल किसी और का था. जिस मैसेज को तुम आज अपना समझ रहे हो वो कल किसी और का था, कल किसी और का होगा. तुम इसे आज अपना समझ के मग्न हो रहे हो, यही तुम्हारे समस्त दुखों का कारण है। बहुत बढ़िया, लाइक, धन्यवाद। इन सभी शब्दों को मन से निकाल दो और निष्काम भाव से मैसेज करो, फिर देखो इस भवसागर रूपी व्हाट्सएप और फेसबुक से कितने भी कुप्रभावों से आप दूर रह के प्रसन्न चित्त का अनुभव कर सकते हो। लाइफ डिफाइंड बाय लाइक्स ऑफ द पीपल एंड लाइफ लाइक्स डिफाइंस फ्रेंडशिप ऑल्सो। टूडे टू गर्ल्स वेर फाइटिंग, यू कॉल मी योर बेस्ट फ्रेंड बट वेर वेर यू वेन माई सेल्फी हैड ओनली 4 लाइक्स। सो फ्रेंडशिप इज ऑल्सो टूडे डिफाइंड बाय likes. Sometimes people send some likes, you know, and WhatsApp has become such a thing, you know. Today only in one group there was sad news of someone expiring, and on one group there was birthday celebration of someone else. So here you have to put emoji, you know, sad face, here you have to put smiling, very good. So WhatsApp can make one sthita pragya, equipoise, not disturbed in any emotion, no matter what happens. So these likes are defining nowadays our friendship also. And to gather more likes, people can go to such an extreme to gather likes. I want more likes. So they will try to capture selfie at such a location where no one has ever gone. Like we have seen that, you know, Tiridi wala. To such an extent. So just to show you some extreme selfies taken by the people. Selfie takers, they want to risk their life, and I have seen many people have lost their lives also while doing this, just to gather more likes to their post. So these electronic gadgets, they have made people so frenzy and crazy about them that family today, if you want to see, it's this, you know. न जाने ये जिंदगी का कौन सा दौर है, न जाने ये जिंदगी का कौन सा दौर है, इंसान खामोश है लेकिन ऑनलाइन पर शोर है। सो ऑनलाइन पीपल आर वेरी मच, यू नो, एक्टिव। दिस इज समटाइम्स पीपल आर इरिटेटेड बीइंग ऑफलाइन, दे हैव टू ऑलवेज, यू नो, सी चेक व्हाट आई हैव रिसीव्ड। बीइंग ऑनलाइन इज द क्रेज, एंड सो मच ऑफ क्रेज, यू नो, दैट वन बॉय वन टाइम हैड लूज मोशंस, Digital India effect, I'm going to share with you. One time one boy had loose motions and he wanted to tell the doctor, but he was very shy. How to tell? So he explained to the doctor in new generation language. Dear doctor, since morning, there is unlimited download. And different ringtones have also started. And there is no balance in the stomach. As soon as I recharge, the balance becomes nil. Can you please disconnect the offer? So that was this online, you know, gadgets language. And uske upar abhi aapko Jio mil jaye to kya pehna? Don't ask. Jio aur jeene do. My God. आजकल के नवयुवक इस ताक में बैठे हैं कि कब मिस्टर अंबानी दारू के धंधे में उतरे और स्कीम निकाले पियो। ताक में बैठे हैं, अनलिमिटेड, पीपल वॉन्ट दिस अनलिमिटेड। न्यू जनरेशन, द जनरेशन ऑफ गैजेट्स, एंड आई कॉल इट ऑल्सो द जनरेशन ऑफ कॉपी एंड पेस्ट। समवन्स लाइफ इज देयर, यू जस्ट कॉपी एंड पेस्ट। सम आइकन यू सी, कॉपी पेस्ट। सम हीरोइज्म यू सी, कॉपी पेस्ट। वी हैव फॉरगॉटन टू लिव अवर ओन लाइव्स, जस्ट कॉपी पेस्ट। समन सेंट, नो, ये लड़कियां कहां से सेल्फी लेके आती है अभी हम लोग समझ पाए, कैसे दिस फ्रॉम वेयर दे गॉट द गॉड कॉपी एंड पेस्ट, कॉपी एंड पेस्ट। कॉपी copy and paste. So we have forgotten to leave our own lives and we have to copy animals also. Unko bhi nahi chhodte hum log. But why don't we learn from these other animals who don't copy anyone and live their own lives? There's few examples of this. Ostrich have totally undeveloped wings, but takes advantage of its long legs and is the fastest runner. Cuckoo, ugly to look at, but does not copy anyone. And what is the singularity of this cuckoo? Sweet voice. Stick to it. And these bats, most of them don't see, but they take the advantage of their hearing aid. They are called as accident free species on the planet. They can't see, but till you will never find any news, two bats head on collision, you will never hear this. Going further in our acronym, life full of focus versus life of distraction. There are so many distractions in your life. Do you agree? When you sit for studying, open the book, keep your phone there, and it rings, ting 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 ting. You are studying, you are determined, I will not look at. And then immediately, sometimes you know it's like goli chala da, no, 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 no. As many, sometimes some people upload photos like this, n number of, and you are again it rings. So you are distracted from your study. Close the book and let us see, something urgent must be there. You open, and there's one post was there, and someone has commented like this, someone has commented like this, someone has commented like this. Different comment, just to see that you are getting distracted from your valuable thing which you are supposed to do. And therefore it said, success is equal to focus minus distraction. Do you agree? Success is equal to focus minus distraction. And these high-tech gadgets and these net-savvy people, they sometimes, for their own frenzy, they forget to take care of another person. How this happens is a clip for all of you. Distraction. So when you are in relationship with your phone, this happens. So don't maintain a long life relationship with these gadgets. That she lost her husband also. So life of focus. So today's gadgets, they distract us. But I'm going to show you some pictures of our age-old games which would teach focus in our life. Some of you might have played this game. Khela hai ki nahi? Develops focus in our life. Khela hai ki nahi? Yes. Now these games will be obsolete, you know. Next generation will not be knowing these games. Only these images I have preserved for them to see. Learning focus in life. Learning focus in life. And height is this. Learning focus in life. So all these games, if you see, they are teaching us to be focused in life. But today's games, they distract you from your main course of action. Study, being attentive, they distract. One example I would like to share. आपने बोल दिया ये तो पुराने फोटो आपने कहीं के दिखाए जो आजकल कोई खेलता भी नहीं है. I'll show you one person, Mr. George Martin. Would you like to know something more about this fellow? Mr. George R. R. Martin, author since 1971, got degree in journalism from Northwestern University and since then started writing. Wrote a book, second book, third book, fourth book. Not a single person read that book. Total failure. Then he got a job and he was placed in CBS, it's a channel in US, where he was given a job of writing a script for the show, and then the show was cancelled. Next time he got placed in ABC, another channel, same thing happened, the show was cancelled. This person continued writing. 20 years later, 1991, he entered into writing fiction books. And then he took the task of completing a series of 7 books entitled The Song of Ice and Fire. Some of you might have heard. And then the first book in that was entitled The Game of Thorns. And it became a blockbuster serial on HBO, which is one of the channels again in US. And he is working on 6th book. The series consists of total 7 books. He is working on 6th book, which is yet to be published. And before publishing, he has sold 25 million copies of that book. 6th book in the series of Ice and Fire. He is one amongst the top 100 richest person in the world. Now what is speciality of this? Why am I discussing this in the point of being focused? This person uses a computer on which internet does not work. Have you heard this WordPress 4? Suna bhi nahi hoga aapne. In 1990s, DOS prompt. So his computer, he writes his book on this DOS prompt, WordPress 4, and he says that I am not on Facebook, I am not on Twitter, and I am not going to be on any such kinds of social networking sites which are going to come in the future. He called them Genie and CompuSolve. These are the names of the future upcoming engines, and I will not be on them, because he says I want to live a life distraction free. A person, one in top 100 richest person in the world, not being on Facebook, not on WhatsApp, not on Twitter. Life full of focus. So when we spend such kind of life in focus, then distractions automatically wave off. Same thing, Krishna also speaks in Bhagavad Gita how to be focused. He says, Vyavasayatmika buddhir ekeha kurunandana bahushakhayanantascha buddhayo vyavasayinam. Vyavasayatmika buddhi ekeha kurunandana. One who is determined, he is single pointed focus. But one who is not, his intelligence is many branched, distracted. So this is how we need to develop a life full of focus and not the life of distraction. Going ahead in our acronym, next I stands for life of instant gratification versus life of long-term payoffs. Like to give an example. How many of you get up early in the morning with the help of alarm clock? So those who have not raised their hands, they might be getting up a little late. So getting early with the help of alarm clock. Whenever you go to bed, put an alarm with the intention of getting up early in the morning and I will do yoga, I will study, I will write something. And then the next day when the alarm rings, my God, the same clock which was your friend one night before becomes your worst enemy. And you want to put it off. Snooze, throw, right? अभी बजना था इसको, मैं तो अभी सोया हूँ. As if I am sleeping just now. That 5 minutes sleep is called as instant gratification. Instant gratification. I want something instant. That too gratification. So the short term and long term. Long term payoff means looking ahead. The person who is looking ahead in his life will be well versed, will be able to give up this instant gratification. And therefore, there is a very nice picture someone sent me. Don't burn your opportunities for a temporary comfort. This person, you know, he has broken down the ladder ठंडी बढ़ गई ना अभी आजकल, सो हैज डन दैट. सो ब्रेकिंग डाउन द स्टेप्स ऑफ द लैडर शेकोटी, टेम्पररी कंफर्ट बट लॉन्ग टर्म लॉस, अ ग्रेट लॉस. एंड भगवद गीता ऑल्सो स्पीक्स अबाउट दिस, हैविंग सम फ्यूचर विजन इन अवर लाइफ. यत्तदग्रे विषमीव परिणामे अमृतोपमम तत्सुखम सात्विकम प्रोक्तम आत्मबुद्धि प्रसादजम. यत्तद अग्रे विषमीव, शुरुआत में जो विष के समान लगता है लेकिन बाद में अमृत परिणित होता है. सुबह जल्दी उठना अलार्म बजने के बाद तुरंत विष के समान प्रतीत होता है, होता है कि नहीं? लेकिन अगर उठेंगे तो बाद में वही आपके लिए अमृत बनने वाला है. एंड दिस कृष्णा कॉल्स दिस एज पीपल इन द मोड ऑफ गुडनेस. नाउ इफ यू कैन रिकॉल बैक इन द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ काइट ऑल्सो वी सॉ दैट वेन यू लिव इन द मोड ऑफ गुडनेस ऊर्ध्वम गच्छन्ति सत्वस्था, द पीपल इन द मोड ऑफ गुडनेस कैन गो हाई. हियर ऑल्सो कृष्णा इज सेइंग दैट पीपल इन द मोड ऑफ गुडनेस कैन हैव फ्यूचर विजन, पीपल इन द मोड ऑफ गुडनेस कैन बी फोकस्ड एंड दे कैन गिव अप इंस्टेंट ग्रेटिफिकेशन. And therefore it said, achievers don't submit to instant gratification, they invest in long-term payoff. Going ahead in our acronym, life of enlightenment versus life of enjoyment. This last E, by the way. When you break down this word into letters, L-I-F-E, life, so it can be life living in full enjoyment, or it can be living in full enlightenment. My dear friends, Sanskrit language is very amazing language, you know. If you want to call someone donkey, gadhe ke jaisa, gadha, you call in Sanskrit, E Vaishakh Nandan. So Gadha in Sanskrit is called as Vaishakh Nandan. You know what an irony is called in Sanskrit? Asta Vyasta Vastra Niyantraka. This is called as Istri. Asta Vyasta Vastra Niyantraka. Do you know what a chain smoker is called in Sanskrit? Anyone knows? Shvet Patra Mandita Dhumra Shalaka Praveena. Shvet Patra, Safed color ka paper, Mandita, covered, Shvet Patra Mandita Dhumra Shalaka. Shalaka is called as mashal, you know? It's like mashal having fire at one end and the pool at the other end. Shvet Patra Mandita Dhumra Shalaka Praveen, he is expert into that. That person is called as chain smoker. Do you know what this is called in Sanskrit? By the way, how about this, having this? Thandi ka season hai, mast. So this in Sanskrit is called as Dudh Sharkara Yukta Heem Ghangol Gattu. Order dene se pehle pigal jayega. दुग्ध शर्करा युक्त, दूध और शक्कर से बनाया हुआ हिम, हिम मीन्स आइस बर्फ, हिम घन गोल गट्टू. और अगर मैंगो आइसक्रीम है तो आम्र दुग्ध शर्करा युक्त हिम घन गोल गट्टू, दिस इज आइसक्रीम. व्हाट इज द टैगलाइन ऑफ आइसक्रीम? एंजॉय इट बिफोर इट मेल्ट्स. एंजॉय before life goes away. So this is one kind of mentality. And there is another thing, it's called as candle. What is the tagline of candle? Is enlighten before it melts. Therefore there is very nice verse written by one Subhashitkar, paropakaram vahanti nadya paropakaram phalanti vriksha परोपकारम दुहंती गाया परोपकारम इदम शरीरम. व्हाट ही सेज, Paropakaram vahanti nadya. All the rivers, they flow because of what? Paropakar. Have you seen any river drinking its own water? No. Have you seen cow? Paropakaram duhanti gaya. Have you seen cow drinking its own milk? No. They give milk for others. Paropakaram phalanti vriksha. Have you seen any time any tree eating its own fruit? No. It gives fruits for the sake of others. Paropakaram idam shariram. So this body is meant for paropakar. So we have to decide, we are members of which club? Ice cream club or candle club? How many of you wants to join candle club? Can you raise your hands? Pravachan ke baad mujhe mil lena. Candle or ice cream. Now I am going to show you some people who are very much handsome, acknowledged for their beauty and strived for, and they are really beautiful. They are really beautiful. Handsome. Do you agree? To some extent? Okay, now you will agree. Beautiful. Handsome. Now I am going to show you the most beautiful and the most handsome person on the entire planet. क्या हो गया आज प्रभु जी को? The most beautiful and the most handsome person on the planet? What are you speaking about? This person, let me tell something about him. His name is Mr. Kalyan Sundaram from Tamil Nadu. Mr. Kalyan Sundaram. He was working as a librarian, and during his 35 years long service as a librarian, he willingly donated all his salary for the betterment of orphan kids. 35 years, everything, not a single penny he used to keep for himself, everything for orphan kids. And during Indochina war, he donated his gold chain to the chief minister of then Tamil Nadu. When he retired as a librarian, whatever pension he received, that also he gave in charity for the betterment of these orphan kids. Not only this, after retirement he worked as a waiter in a hotel in exchange for 2 meals a day and a meager salary. That also he would continue to donate to the orphanages. And we Indians, when we were busy in watching the shows of these personalities which I shown on previous slides, United States of America, they recognized this person. They recognized this person that there was only one person on the entire planet who dedicated single penny, each and every penny of his salary for the cause of social welfare, and they gave him a title, Man of the Millennium. And when he became Man of the Millennium, in the award, he received rupees 30 crore. That also he donated for the social welfare. So therefore we say, if you really wants to become handsome, if you really wants to become handsome, extend your hand to some. Extend your hand to someone. That is the way to become really handsome. A mother would always ask her son, "My dear son, do you know what is the most important part of the body?" The son was growing. So son would always have this question, "Why my mother is asking this?" So as he was growing, the mother would keep asking, "Do you know what is the most important part of our body, my dear son?" The son, as he was growing, one day he said, "Sound seems to be the best." "So my dear mother, ear are the best part of our body." Mother replied, "No, my dear son, there are many people on this planet who are deaf, can't hear. So ear is not the best part of our body." Years passed by. Mother keep asking the same question to the son. My dear son, what is the best part of our body? One time, this child replied, sight is most important, therefore I think eyes are the most important part of our body. Mother said, my dear son, you are becoming smarter every year. But the answer is wrong. Eyes, there are many people on the planet who are blind, who can't see. So eyes are not the best part of our body. Years were passing by. One time, the grandfather in the family expired. Everyone was hurted. All of the people in the family were crying like anything, including the father of the child, whom he has never seen cry. First time he was seeing his father also cry. So traumatic situation the family was going through. And there was the last time they were going to say goodbye to their grandfather. And the mother asked the child, my dear son, do you know what is the best part of your body? The child was amazed, taken aback. Is this the time to ask this question? I was always thinking, this is the game between my mother and me. But at such a crucial time, she is asking me this question. And then the child was looking at the mother. And the mother was looking at the child with tears in her eyes. And she said, my dear son, this is the right time for you to learn this lesson. Do you know what is the most important part of our body? She said, the most important part of our body are our shoulders. And then the son immediately said, Why our shoulders are very important part of the body? Because they can hold my head high up in the air. And then the mother said, no, my dear son. Why shoulders are the most important part of our body is because they can give support to someone, your loved one, when they want to cry. And therefore, shoulders are the most important part of our body. And then the mother said, I hope that you gather so much of love in your life that whenever someone needs the shelter or you need the shelter, there you will find someone's shoulder for you to cry. And then the boy understood that all through these years my mother was asking, what is the best part of the body? The best part of the body is not for selfish cause. The best part of the upper body is that part which can give support to others. That is the best part of the body. And therefore I say, when I is replaced by we, even illness becomes wellness. Illness becomes wellness. When I was in school, we were taught some prayers. Janakalyani deha jizavne lazavile chandana. What do you mean by this? Janakalyani, for the welfare of the world. Deha jizavne. We are exhausting our bodies, dedicating our body for social welfare. Lazavile chandana. Even the chandan, sandal is feeling shame on itself that this person apne jeevan ko itna ghis raha hai, vyakti ki samaj ko itna sugandh de raha hai ki mujhe sharam aa rahi hai. Who is thinking? Chandan. Janakalyani deha jizavne lazavile chandana. Karma viraho, jnana viraho, lakh lakh vandana. I offered my lakhs and lakhs of obeisances, pranams to such kinds of persons who have dedicated their lives for the sake of others. And I am going to show you one last video of today's session. The person who has dedicated his life mainly for the sake of some higher principles. And as you know, 26th January is coming up. And I mean what by this? Mr. Arun Kshetrapal, at the age of 21, the person who got youngest Paramvir Chakra award. And therefore we say, Zindagi aisi na jiyo ki log phiryat kare. Zindagi aisi na jiyo ki log phiryat kare. Zindagi aisi jiyo ki log tumhe phir yaad kare. Yaad kare. And therefore, the take-home message for this today's session, we'd like to conclude with this. When you go home, even if you can't carry anything, just carry this one simple slide with you, engrave it in your heart. If you are beautiful, it's God's gift to you. If you are beautiful, it's God's gift to you. But if you live your life beautiful, it's your gift to God. So let us live that kind of life full of beauty with selfie. With S stands for life of substance and not living the life of just show off. E, life of edification, living in sattvaguna, going high like a kite and not just the life of degradation. L, living a life full of love and not just likes. F, living a life with full of focus and not the life of distraction. I, not living the life of instant gratification, being patient and looking for some long-term payoffs in our life. And E, last but not the least, living with full enlightenment and not the enjoyment. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
So let us thank Krishnan Prabhu by a huge round of applause for sharing his valuable wisdom with us.